Ladies and gentlemen, hey, hi, how you doing? Welcome back to the channel. Over the past few days, we've had quite a bit of stuff going on in the world of Call of Duty. Between the latest teasers for Black Ops Cold War and all the new Pawn Takes Pawn Easter eggs for that, and of course, the Modern Warfare and Warzone Season 6 hype as well. And yesterday, the hype continued, as Infinity Ward actually revealed some brand new details on the major map change that we're getting in Season 6 regarding the metro stations. Now, we've known for a while that the metro or the subway stations were planned to be coming to Warzone, but now we have even more info as to how they're actually going to work. And also, the map that Infinity Ward revealed shows some very interesting things that may have a much larger impact on the map as we get later on into the season. So, as we go over everything today, if you enjoy the video at any point, let me know by dropping a like on it. And of course, if you're new to the channel, we are working towards hitting 600,000 subscribers before Cold War releases, so if you want to keep up with the latest Call of Duty news, intel, updates, and pretty much everything else going on, feel free to subscribe with your notifications turned on. Now, first and foremost, as I said, Infinity Ward actually shared a map of what this metro system is going to be like, then they also released some additional details on how it's going to work. And there's honestly some pretty cool things they've implemented into the system itself. But as far as this map goes, this of course highlights these 7 stations that we've already known about from the Season 6 cinematic video. As we've got the one that's over at the airport, we've got one at Lazov Pass, one at the Verdansk Center, one inside of downtown, one in the shopping district, one at the train station, and then finally one at the Torsk block area as well. Now you'll notice they're also color-coded so you can see which subway runs to certain locations. So for instance, you can go from Verdansk International Airport over to Lazov Pass, but you can't go from the airport over to the Verdansk Center or over into downtown. However, it may not always be like that, because as you'll notice in the Service 2 section of this map, we see the 7 stations that we already know of, but then we also have the out of service one as well, and you can actually see some of the out of service lines on the map, and some of them lead to some rather interesting places, if I do say so myself. So, for instance, over by the train station, you can see an out-of-service line that runs to the north and then to the west edge of the map. And it just so happens that on that western side of the map lies a bunker. And we know by now that the bunkers have those second doorways inside that we haven't been able to open up all year long. So perhaps eventually, maybe with the launch of Season 6, maybe later on into the season, we could see some of these metro stations actually connect to the various bunkers that we have all around the map. Now, another very convenient out-of-service one would be just outside of Lazov Pass. You'll notice there's a line that runs to the northwest towards the military base area, and, as we know, Bunker 11 is just beyond that area directly. So it certainly seems like some of these out-of-service lines may be more than what just meets the eye. I guess only time is going to tell if something is going to happen with those, but come Season 6, I'm just saying, there may be some extra things included with this new metro system. Also, something else I wanted to point out about this map that Infinity Ward revealed is that in the bottom right, it actually says, "Please be advised, in the event of an environmental hazard occurring at a destination, the train will continue operation to the nearest safe station on the line." AKA, the train is not going to run into the gas, which is what's being referenced there. Now, outside of the map itself, we also got a pretty detailed blog post breaking down what the metro system is going to be like and just basically how it's going to work. So, first of all, this is apparently going to be a fast travel system, meaning you're going to pop into the metro by downtown, then pop out over at the stadium pretty quickly. So it's not going to be like the full travel time from point A to point B, and instead it's just going to be a fast travel, at least from the sounds of this. So it should just be a quick trip in and out once you actually are on the train and moving. So that means if you're trying to escape the zone, if you're trying to get away from somebody hunting you, or even on the contrary, if you're trying to get closer to someone you're hunting, these fast travels could actually be really, really useful. Now, this blog also says that all the metro stations, regardless of where they're located, are going to have the same layout inside. So yeah, if you get lost, that is 100% on you. You can't be letting that happen. And then on the inside of the metro area, there's actually going to be more to it than just the trains in that area itself. IW says there's going to be different platforms depending on which direction you're trying to go. There's also going to be areas for ground loot and supply boxes and even contracts to spawn. So there's going to be a decent amount of room to actually explore inside of each of the stations. Now, only 2 of these metro locations are actually going to be new to the map. Those being the one at Lazov Pass, which you guys can see on the screen right now, and this is going to be located just outside the apartments there. Then, of course, the one over at the stadium is also going to be brand new, and this is going to be just on the eastern side of the stadium over on the road there. Also, every single subway station is going to have an emergency exit in a sense, and these are going to be there in the form of an escape ladder, which actually leads up to the surface a few dozen meters away from the main entrance to whatever subway station you're at. So definitely remember that those are going to be a thing, and if you're like me, you're probably going to have to make sure you don't fall into them and die to fall damage. I have a really bad feeling that's going to happen more than once on stream, but we shall see. Now, these trains do actually have a very specific rule set that they follow, which I will say is probably one of the more interesting things about them. So here, Infinity Ward says that the trains are not going to move to any stations that are actually within the gas, so you can't go and travel into the gas and try to flank or anything like that. Then, while you're on the train itself, if there are any fights taking place in any sort of fashion, the train is not going to move. So, say you're fighting a team and you go to jump onto the train, if you're still shooting while you're on it, you're not going to be able to escape until you stop shooting completely. I would say this also applies if there's any fighting between the train and the platform as well, so while inside of the metros, you are only going to be able to fight if you're on the platforms, the stairs, or in the entrance area. Otherwise, the train is probably just going to be full of loot because you're not going to be able to escape. Now, Infinity Ward also says that if you touch the tracks there whatsoever, they're basically going to act just like the water does all across the map, and you are going to be instantly killed. Even if you're playing in duos or trios or quads, you're not going to go down. You're just simply going to fall over then and there and be sent straight to the gulag or to the spectator screen or even back to the lobby. So definitely mind the gap. Make sure you do not step on the tracks. Again, I'm probably going to forget that. I can already see myself like mid-gunfight trying to slide to escape and somehow just ending up in the gulag, not because an enemy shot me, but because I touched the tracks and fell over. So definitely be sure to remember that those are going to be live, they're going to be active, and they will insta-kill you if you touch them. Anyways, it seems that Infinity Ward and Raven are really going all in with these metro systems this season, which, I won't lie, still feels like a bit of a weird map update, considering it is all underneath the actual surface of the map. I know I would really like to see some other areas changed around a bit, maybe even removed. By all means, if downtown were to just disappear, or if the ATC tower over at the airport were to be teleported into a black hole, I wouldn't say I'd be necessarily disappointed, but for now, it seems the majority of the map changes for Season 6 are going to revolve around the metro systems. So yeah, with all of that being said, that is what we now know about what seems to be the biggest of the map updates for Season 6 of Call of Duty Warzone. And that is going to wrap things up for today. If you guys enjoyed the video, let me know by dropping a like on it. And of course, if you're new here, if you want to help us reach 600k before Black Ops Cold War releases, feel free to subscribe to stay on top of the latest Call of Duty news, intel, updates, and pretty much everything in between. As always, if you want to check out any of my partners, be sure to use code IMMORTAL for a spicy discount on all Scuf, G Fuel, and Control Freak products. All of those links can be found down in the description below. And once again, thanks so much for tuning in. Until next time, take it easy, have an awesome rest of your day, and I'll catch you guys later. Peace out.